저희가 예수를 맡음에 예수께서 자기의 십자가를 지시고 해골, 히브리 말로 골고다라 하는 곳에 나오시니 저희가 거기서 예수를 십자가에 못 박을 새 다른 두 사람도 그와 함께 좌우편에 못 박으니 예수는 가운데 있더라.
매주 금요일 예루살렘에서는 예수 생애 마지막 발자취를 따르는 중세의식이 치러진다. 일명 비아 돌로로사라는 십자가의 길에는 예수의 고통스러운 여정을 기르는 14처가 있다. 십자가의 길이 끝나는 곳은 예수가 십자가에 못 박히고 무덤에 묻힌 후 부활한 장소로서 오늘날 성묘 교회가 위치한 곳이다. 바로 곁에 위치한 예배당의 둥근 천장 아래에는 모든 기독교 성지 중에 가장 성스럽게 여겨지는 예수의 무덤이 있다.
The rotunda has in the middle of it an edifice which marks the burial place and place of resurrection. We are now in a chapel which is in its present day shape dating back to the early 19th century. And it replaces the rock-hewn chamber which once stood here, inside which there was the burial of Christ.
예수의 무덤에는 지금까지 1700년 가까이 순례자들의 발길이 끊이지 않고 있다. 그렇다면 과연 이 장소는 정확한 것일까? 이 질문에 답하기 위한 여정은 전혀 뜻밖의 장소인 로마 제국에서 시작된다. 서기 325년, 로마 황제로서는 최초의 기독교도였던 콘스탄틴 누수 대제는 예수가 묻히고 부활한 장소에 웅장한 교회를 세우라는 명령을 내렸다. 그로부터 2년 후, 황제 모후 헬레나는 예루살렘으로 순례를 떠나게 되는데 일각에서는 헬레나가 순례를 떠난 목적이 교회를 지을 정확한 장소를 물색하기 위해서라고 주장한다.
What she brought was money, not knowledge. And to determine these places, she just asked the locals.
And they tell her a very strange place. They say he's buried under the Temple of Venus. You know, well, wait a minute. How can that be?
현재의 기독교도들은 헬레나 황후에게 서기 70년경 로마 군인들이 예루살렘을 파괴했다고 설명했다. 그리고 하드리아누스 황제가 예루살렘을 재건하면서 예수의 무덤을 흙으로 덮어버리고 아프로디테 여신에게 바치는 신전을 지었다고 말했다. 헬레나 황후는 이 말을 듣고 경악했다. 황후는 비너스 조각상을 즉시 치워버리고 흙을 파내도록 명령했다. 그러자 놀랍게도 이교도들의 신전 밑에서 고대 무덤이 나왔다.
This is rather spectacular when you think of it. After digging way down there, deeper than anybody alive had ever seen before, they do find some tombs.
Whether or not she hit the exact tomb is very speculative, but the fact that she did dig and find a series of tombs gives some plausibility to the fact that she might be in the right spot.
이곳이 정확한 장소라고 확신한 콘스탄티누스 대제는 예수의 무덤이 있던 장소에다 웅장한 복합 사원 단지를 짓도록 명령했다.
And then, of course, they had a problem, because if you have a tomb which is below ground and you want to incorporate it into a church, you've got to then cut away the rock all around in order to fit it into some kind of building edifice. So this is exactly what was done.
He cut the existing hill into two cubical rock formations. One of them was the place upon which traditionally the cross stood, the place of crucifixion or Golgotha. And the other one was a cubical rock, which included inside it the tomb of Christ, wherefrom he resurrected.
The 공사 기간 10년이 걸린 이 최초의 성묘 교회는 서기 335년 헌정되었고, 완성되자마자 기독교계에서 가장 중요한 성지가 되었다. 성묘 교회의 명성과 함께 헬레나 황후를 둘러싼 전설도 인구에 회자되기 시작했다. 기독교에서 중요하게 여겨지는 유물엔 어김없이 헬레나 황후의 이름이 따라다녔고, 그중엔 예수가 실제로 못 박혔다는 진짜 십자가도 포함되어 있다. 오늘날 성묘 교회의 지하에 있는 예배당은 이 진짜 십자가의 발견을 기념하기 위해 건립됐다.
We are now in the subterranean part, which is the chapel of the invention of the cross. This part, which has here this small altar where we see the candles lit, this is the very spot in which Empress Helena found allegedly the true cross.
그러나 박해희 박사는 이것이 허구라고 주장한다.
This place was not opened and was not revealed during the early Christian period. It was penetrated only in the medieval period.
일부 학자들은 헬레나 황후와 성묘 교회 사이엔 아무런 관계가 없다고 주장한다.
The historically reliable sources don't connect Helena with the finding of the cross nor with the finding of the tomb. And at the moment she went to Jerusalem, there's no mention about any connection between Helena and the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. This connection is a later tradition.
그러나 모두 다 이 의견에 동의하는 건 아니다.
I do believe in the finding of the cross. I think that there was something that took place because otherwise there would be no reason for the Jerusalem church to accept that the crucifixion place was where Helena said it would have to be.
We're quite sure that Helena did find a first century tomb on the site where the Church of the Holy Sepulchre is currently located.
When Helena came to Jerusalem, she commissioned a church on the site on which Jesus had died. As they excavated, I'm quite sure with their fingers crossed, they did actually find the tomb that had been venerated in the memory of Jerusalem. Now, whether she was present or not, I have no idea. I don't think she stayed around that long.
헬레나 황후의 업적이 어디까지가 사실인지 분명치 않지만 콘스탄티누스 황제가 세운 최초의 교회는 그 자리를 700년 가까이 지켰다. 그러던 서기 1009년, 격변하는 주변 정세로 인해 교회도 무사하지 못했다.
There was a terrible Fatimid caliph called Al-Hakim who came to Jerusalem and ordered that all the Christian churches should be destroyed, including the tomb of Jesus. So the tomb of Jesus itself was tremendously cut into, almost completely obliterated. Everything of the superstructures of the basilica were destroyed.
그로부터 한 세기 가까운 세월이 흘러 1099년이 돼서야 십자군이 예루살렘을 점령하고 새로운 교회를 세웠다. 그 후 이 교회는 여러 차례 증축 공사와 개조를 거치면서 다양한 양식이 혼합된 형태를 띠게 됐다.
This building, not very beautiful, but at the same time most interesting. This building is kind of a history book, which includes pages of different periods. If one looks at the works of art in the church, some of them may be evidence of bad taste. Some of them may be very valuable works of art. It's an incredible mixture of different dates, different tastes, different types of art, different levels of workmanship.
Time 흐르면서 다양한 종파 간에는 교회를 놓고 분쟁이 벌어졌고 그 결과 기독교 정신에 반하는 폭력을 불러오기도 했다. 그러던 1852년 투르코 황제의 칙령으로 오랜 분쟁은 끝을 맺는다. 하지만 그것은 새로운 분쟁의 불씨가 됐다. 지금도 성녀 교회의 신빙성을 놓고 각 종파 간에는 치열한 설전이 벌어지고 있다.
There was a great desire among Protestants to prove that the tomb was actually somewhere else where they could pray.
1800년대 중반, 예수가 묻히고 부활한 장소인 성묘 교회의 관할권을 두고 분쟁이 일기 시작했다.
Today, the Church of the Holy Sepulchre is divided among a number of different groups. The three biggest ones are the Greek Orthodox, the Armenian Orthodox, and the Roman Catholics. And they have always been in conflict, partly because they're just there. You see, they're just holding possession. And they don't have quite enough to do, so, you know, people get bored and there are spats.
1852년, 투르크 제국의 술탄 압둘 메지드는 이러한 분쟁을 해소하고자 21쪽에 달하는 현상 유지 법안을 발표했다. 오늘날까지도 사용되고 있는 이 법안은 각 종파가 언제, 어떻게 관할권을 행사할 수 있는지 자세히 명시하고 있다.
That's why even today in the Roman Catholic section, the Mass is in Latin, not the vernacular as in the rest of the world, because that was the language when the treaty was made, you see.
그런데 현상 유지법이 지금도 문제가 되는 건 여기서 명시하고 있지 않은 부분 때문이다.
This holy sepulcher here was already divided up between the different denominations and the Westerners, i.e. the Protestants, they came last. There was no part left for them.
And so there was a great desire among Protestants to prove that the Armenians and Greeks and Catholics were all wrong and that the tomb was actually somewhere else where they could pray.
One of the reasons that pilgrims visiting Jerusalem in the 1800s had trouble in accepting the Holy Sepulchre as the correct position was because they could see very clearly it was within the walls of the old city. And we know that Jesus was taken outside the city wall to be crucified. Burial is always outside the city wall, and very definitely the death sentence would have been carried on outside the wall.
영국에서 가장 존경받는 군인 중 하나인 찰스 차이니스 고든 장군은 1882년 예루살렘을 방문해 성묘 교회를 둘러싼 논쟁에 일침을 가했다.
General Gordon was a mystic, an unusual person in many ways, and when he was here in Jerusalem, it was very clear that he was dissatisfied with the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. And he became convinced that the quarry area outside Damascus Gate, that was the site of the crucifixion.
1년의 불가사의한 상징을 추적하던 고든 장군은 예루살렘 북쪽에 있는 언덕을 탐험하다 인간의 해골과 흡사한 모양을 가진 바위 절벽에 이르렀다.
He thought he saw two eyes in the big cliff. Ah, this is the head. This is a skull. This is the place of the skull. This is the place of execution.
He, in fact, wrote to Queen Victoria and said, we have discovered Golgotha, Mom. She was not best impressed, not least because Queen Victoria is related to the
the family that had authenticated the Holy Sepulchre as the traditional site. But his views were published, and that's why they started looking all round this area for evidence of a rich man's Jewish tomb that fitted the details of Scripture.
아리마대 사람 요셉이 빌라도더러 예수의 시체를 가져가기를 구함에 빌라도가 허락하는지라. 예수의 십자가에 못 박히신 곳에 동산이 있고 동산 안에 아직 사람을 장사한 일이 없는 새 무덤이 있는지라. 이날은 유대인의 예배일이요 또 무덤이 가까운 거로 예수를 거기 두니라.
고든 장군의 주장을 지지하던 사람들은 인근 동산을 샅샅이 뒤지다가 몇 해 전 발굴됐던 바위 무덤을 보게 됐다. 그들은 이것이야말로 진짜 예수의 무덤인 동산 무덤이라고 주장했다.
So we're now going down to the tomb itself, a tomb which is cut out of the solid rock. And you can see along the facade of the cliff there, the original rock, very clearly, not a natural cave, but clearly a man-made tomb. And to remind you that the tomb of Jesus was not a natural cave, it was hewn out of the rock. And as we come into the tomb, we can see, in fact, it's a large tomb. Only a very rich person could afford to build a tomb this size just for his own exclusive family use. In the tomb, there are two graves. There's one on this side, which has a stone pillow for the head over there and a place cut out of the rock for the feet. And the custom in those days was to prepare the tomb for burial, but only to cut the place for the feet when you knew the size of the person to be buried. This is the grave which we think may have been used if it is actually the tomb of Jesus. So it does seem to fit together, and it fits all the details of Scripture. A rich man's Jewish tomb in a garden so close to the possible crucifixion site.
1894년 캔터베리 대주교가 이끄는 발굴팀은 해골 언덕과 무덤을 둘러싼 주변 지역을 구입하여 동산무덤협회를 설립했다.
Some people make slightly patronizing remarks that the Protestants felt excluded from the Holy Sepulchre and therefore they wanted to create their own shrine there where they would feel comfortable. But I've read enough of the literature to know that they genuinely believe that this could be the actual site of the death and the burial of Jesus.
하지만 누구나 동산 무덤을 인정한 건 아니다. 동산 무덤을 처음 발굴한 클로드 콘도는 1909년 개신교의 주장을 반박하는 논문을 발표했다. 그 후 이곳에서 발굴 작업을 벌인 고고학자들도 지속적인 의문을 표시했다.
An archaeological investigation of the garden tomb showed beyond any doubt that that burial cave belongs to the first temple period, to the Iron Age. It is a 7th or 8th century BC tomb. It could not be the new tomb of Joseph of Arimathea, unused before. It doesn't show any characteristics of second temple period.
You know, I really wish the garden tomb was the burial place of Jesus. It is such a lovely spot. But I'm afraid it's not. The garden tomb is a typical bench tomb from the Iron Age, several centuries before Jesus, which is, I'm afraid, much too early to be the burial place of Jesus. And by the way, no, there's no evidence of reuse of those tombs during the time of Jesus. A lovely spot, but not the tomb of Jesus.
그럼에도 불구하고 오늘날까지도 이곳 정원 무덤이 예수의 무덤이라 굳게 믿는 사람들이 있다.
The Garden Tomb Association, from its founding and still today, has never categorically claimed that this is definitely the site of the death and the burial of Jesus. Not least because as Christian believers we want to respect the integrity of those who serve at the Church of the Holy Sepulchre and those who believe and teach that that is the site. So our position is, it may be, it might be, it could be, and many people believe that it is.
한편 일부에서는 1세기 예루살렘을 정확히 재건하려는 프로젝트에 착수했다. 성묘교회의 정통성을 둘러싼 논란이 계속되고 있는 가운데 고고학자들은 이 문제를 학문적으로 해결하고자 노력을 기울였다. 그러나 한 가지 큰 문제가 있었다.
There were very few excavations in the Holy Sepulchre because of the sensitivity of the site and because you have to get permission of the church authorities to do any work inside the site. And digging up their floors is not something they're particularly interested in.
성묘교회 당국에서 경례를 파헤치는 걸 꺼려하자 고고학자들은 성묘교회의 정통성을 밝힐 다른 방법을 찾아야 했다. 그래서 찾은 방법이 예수 시대 예루살렘 도시 경계선이 어디 위치해 있는가를 밝히는 것이었다.
If the Holy Sepulchre was outside the wall, as traditionally believed, it could very definitely have been the possible location. So the big, as it were, the $24,000 question is, where was the wall at the time that Jesus was crucified?
콘스탄티누스가 이 교회를 지었을 때, 이곳은 분명 로마인들이 재건한 예루살렘 성벽 내에 위치해 있었다. 뿐만 아니라 서기 41년, 아그리파 왕이 지은 일명 제3성벽 내에 위치한 것도 분명하다. 그러나 한 가지 정확하지 않은 점은 예수 시대에 있었던 정확한 성벽의 위치가 어디였는가 하는 점이다. 일명 제2의 성벽으로 불리는 이 문제의 벽은 어느 지도에도 나와 있지 않다. 오직 고대 역사가인 플라비우스 요세푸스의 기록에만 간단히 언급되어 있을 뿐이다.
제2 성벽은 사람들이 게나스라 부르는 문에서부터 시작되는데 이 문은 제1 성벽의 일부다. 제2 성벽은 도시의 북쪽으로 4분의 1을 둘러싸고 있으며 안토니아 요새까지 뻗어 있다.
Konrad Schick was an architect antiquarian working in the 19th century, and he dug a very deep shaft on the east side of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, and he came across a very sharp scarp, a rock kind of cliff, and beneath it was a large pile of dressed stones which seemed to have come from a fortification wall. I personally believe that these stones came from the second wall of Jerusalem, but without a proper archaeological excavation done with modern methods, we can't really be certain about this being the second wall.
1세기 예루살렘 성벽을 찾을 길이 없다면 어떻게 성묘교회가 정확한 장소라는 걸 판명할 수 있을 것인가? 고고학자들은 고심했다. 그때 이 난해한 문제를 해결할 수 있다고 등장한 사람이 있었다. 그는 영국의 여류 고고학자 캐슬린 캐니언 부인이었다. 1961년 예루살렘 기독교 지구에서 발굴 작업을 하던 캐니언 부인은 예수 시대 성 밖에 위치한 채석장으로 보이는 장소를 찾아냈다. 일명 시구역으로 명명된 이곳은 성묘교회와 매우 근접해 있었기 때문에 캐니언 부인은 어쩌면 이곳에 예수의 무덤과 관련된 증거가 있을지도 모른다고 생각했다. 시구역은 2세기까지만 해도 예루살렘 성벽 밖에 위치해 있었기 때문에 예수가 십자가형에 처해질 당시 성묘교회 역시 성벽 외곽에 위치했다는 얘기가 된다. 물론 아직까지는 이 교회가 갈보리에 정확히 위치했다는 증거가 없지만 어쩌면 여기서 단서가 나올지도 모른다. 그로부터 3년 후 캐니언 부인의 주장은 프란치스코의 소속 고고학자 비르힐리오 코르보 신부에 의해 확인됐다. Sangmyo교회의 토대를 확인하기 위해 13군데의 도랑을 판 코르보 신부는 교회 밑을 철저히 조사해 보기로 했다.
Actually, if you look at the floor of the courtyard and the floors of the building, there are removable stone slabs and wooden slabs covering pits in the floor.
These are the archaeological excavations which were carried out by Virgilio Corbo, one of the Franciscan archaeologists who carried out the work inside the church.
코르보 신부의 조사 결과, 성묘 교회 밑에는 예수 시대에 존재했던 거대한 채석장이 있는 걸로 드러났다. 이것은 캐슬린 캐니언 부인이 주장했던 바와 일치하는 것이다.
They can find evidence of quarrying all around that area. The width is about 150 meters, length about 200 meters of this old quarry. So it's way beyond the perimeter of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre as well.
성묘 교회터가 채석장이었다는 가장 확실한 증거는 십자가 발견 예배당 안에서 볼 수 있다.
In fact, this is a cave in bedrock. One can see the rocky ceiling, and upon the ceiling, one can see the signs of the removal, the scars of stones which were removed from here by the quarriers. This quarry activity shows no doubt that the place then was outside the city. They wouldn't quarry under their own houses.
고고학계에서는 성묘 교회 밑에서 고대 채석장의 흔적이 발견됨에 따라 이곳이 예수의 진짜 무덤일 가능성이 높다고 인정했으나 일부에서는 여전히 의심스러워했다. 그런데 또 다른 놀라운 발견을 통해 학계의 의구심은 완전히 사라지게 된다. 고고학자들이 골고다 언덕을 본격적으로 조사하기 시작한 것이다.
It would have been logistically impossible, as far as I can see, for the Roman soldiers to have crucified three people on top of it.
비르힐리오 코르보 신부가 벌인 최초의 발굴 작업이 성공하자 다른 학자들도 이곳으로 몰려들었다.
The different communities in charge of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre undertook their own separate excavations in different places. So the Armenians excavated in their area behind the Chapel of St. Vartan and also below the floor. And the Greek Orthodox Church excavated around the Rock of Calvary. They came up with some very interesting artifacts and data that really helps us understand exactly what was going on at the time of Jesus.
Let's get inside.
1970년대 아르메니안 정교회 소속 고고학자들은 이곳에서 그전까지 알려지지 않았던 여러 개의 공간을 발견했는데 이곳은 평소 일반인들에게 공개되지 않고 있다.
This is the Chapel of St. Vartan and the Armenian Martyrs. It is actually one of the most fascinating places within this complex of the Holy Sepulchre. It is part of the same stone quarry that we witnessed before. It is topped by a rocky roof, which is made of less suitable rocks for construction purposes and therefore left as a roof by the quarriers. And inside you can see the marks of the quarrying.
이 비밀의 동굴을 더욱 깊숙이 파들어가자. 이 지역의 오래되고 복잡한 역사가 고스란히 드러나기 시작했다.
Here one can see the exposed bedrock.
It was very exciting. And of course, there were very important archaeological finds which date back to the Iron Age and later remains, including the Hadrianic Forum and also remnants of the foundations of the Basilica of Constantine the Great.
그 중에서도 가장 놀라운 발견은 성바르탄 교회 내부에서 이루어졌다. 박해희 박사는 이것이 4세기 초의 것이라 추정하고 있다.
on top of one of the stones, the smoothed surface of it showed remnants of fresco painted onto the face of the stone, and it showed the image of a vessel. And underneath the vessel, there is a Latin inscription saying, Domine Ivimus, the Lord we went, which is a kind of an answer to the words of Psalms saying, let us get up and go to the place of the Lord in Jerusalem. So this is the answer, the Lord we went. This is a statement of pilgrims. This is the earliest evidence of pilgrimage to this place, and this proves that even prior to the Constantinian construction of the first Christian edifice at this point, the place was venerated by pilgrims.
그러나 많은 학자들이 박해이 박사의 이론에 이의를 제기하면서 이 벽화는 1세기 하드리아누스 황제가 세운 도시에 살던 이교도들이 남긴 것이라 주장한다. 하지만 이러한 논란은 갈보리산을 둘러싼 새로운 논란에 비하면 아무것도 아니다. 골고다라고도 불리는 이곳은 예수의 십자가형이 이루어진 곳으로 전해지고 있다.
At this spot, we have an elevated rock, which is a remnant of a larger rocky hill, which was sawn by Emperor Constantine and was left as a rocky outcrop upon which this chapel is built today. Now, underneath the altar, bedrock is exposed, and there is a silver circle marking the place where the cross actually stood.
1988년 그리스 정교회 소속 고고학자들은 갈보리 바위 주변의 바닥에 깔린 돌을 모두 치우고 900년 만에 처음으로 고대 채석장을 조사하기 시작했다. 그 결과는 매우 놀라운 것이었다.
For the first time, it was understood that the Rock of Calvary was a kind of little finger pointing up from the floor of the quarry. It was extremely high and really quite thin, and also almost hollow in one place. So it was obvious why it was left by the quarriers. It was because the rock was so useless.
갈보리 바위를 자세히 조사한 테일러 박사는 이곳이 예수의 십자가형 장소가 아니란 결론을 내렸다.
It would have been logistically impossible for the Roman soldiers to have crucified three people on top of it. It's not particularly wide. And the Roman soldiers would have had to have stood at the bottom and somehow hauled people up this rather strange structure to crucify them on top of it. So, you know, there's various things about the traditional site of the crucifixion, which is the Rock of Calvary, that just simply do not match with the New Testament story. It's too difficult to put these two things together.
그러나 일부 학자들의 의견은 또 다르다.
Look, what we have today from the Rock of Calvary is only a small piece. It could have been larger.
We can't actually be absolutely certain that the rock at the time of the crucifixion wasn't double the size or three times the size. And so I can't completely agree with the idea put forward by Joan Taylor that this is an impossibility. There's always a possibility. However, I think the term Golgotha refers to the general area rather than to a specific feature. And so the crucifixion could have taken place anywhere in that area.
테일러 박사 역시 이 의견에는 동의하면서 예수가 십자가형에 처해진 골고다라는 채석장은 현재 위치에서 13km 떨어진 또 다른 장소라고 주장한다.
I think that the crucifixion site was close to Gennath Gate, and Gennath Gate was identified by Avigad, so we know where that was, and you would expect a roadway to be leading west from there. So I think that Jesus was crucified somewhere along that western road so that there could be people passing by hurling insults at him. And this indicates it was further south than the traditional location of the crucifixion, still within just the border of the old quarry, but 200 metres south of the tomb rather than 40 metres east of it. So the site of the crucifixion in today's Jerusalem is somewhere along David Street.
그러나 예루살렘에서 가장 복잡한 길 중 하나인 이곳을 모두 파헤치자는 한 논란은 쉽게 가라앉지 않을 것이다.
I have the feeling that the location of the place of the crucifixion is thereabouts. But where exactly, one can't know for certain.
그렇다면 이제 남은 질문은 하나. 성묘 교회는 정말 예수의 무덤이 있을까?
Of the possible candidates, the best chance of being the true site is the Church of the Holy Sepulchre.
성묘 교회 밑에서 벌어지고 있는 최근의 발굴 작업을 통해 이 교회의 역사에 대한 단서가 많이 발견됐다. 그러나 많은 학자들은 이곳에서 정작 중요한 단서는 다른 곳에 있다고 말한다.
It is a place which was not restored as the rest of the places. This is a small chapel which belongs to the Syrian church, and it includes a small chamber inside which bedrock is exposed. In bedrock there is an ancient burial cave. That cave is, according to tradition, the tomb of Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus. The cave is a typical Second Temple period cave, something which is rather characteristic to the time of Jesus.
학자들은 이 동굴이야말로 이곳이 1세기에 공동 묘지였다는 증거이며 지금은 화려하게 장식된 예수 무덤의 본 모습을 보여주는 것이라고 주장한다.
This is the best proof to the problem of the authenticity of the Holy Sepulchre. We have here actually a tomb which dates back to Second Temple period.
It's unmistakable. So Helena did find a first century Jewish cemetery. There's no question about that.
For me, as an archaeologist, this small, rather neglected corner of this very complex edifice is one of the most significant points inside the church.
고고 학자들은 성묘 교회 밑에서 발견된 여러 가지 흔적으로 미루어 볼 때 이곳이 예수가 묻혔던 곳이 거의 분명하다고 주장한다.
Of the possible candidates, the one that I think has far and away the best chance of being the true site is the Church of the Holy Sepulchre.
I think the Church of the Holy Sepulchre is the right place. What we find beneath the Church of the Holy Sepulchre corresponds exactly to what we have in the Gospels.
I'm a believer in tradition. I think one has to accept tradition, unless, of course, you have good, strong archaeological evidence to the contrary.
I don't think we can ever have conclusive evidence, but the evidence taken as a whole does suggest that could be the very place where Jesus was executed and buried.
I hope we never will be able to. Because if somebody was ever able to prove that this is the tomb where Jesus was definitely buried, a very sad thing will happen. And that is that people will start to worship the tomb. People will be venerating the tomb. Don't worship the tomb, please. Worship the risen Lord Jesus, because that's our ministry at the Garden Tomb, to point people to Jesus who died, who was buried, but who rose again.
문득 찬란한 옷을 입은 두 사람이 곁에 섰는지라. 어찌하여 산자를 죽은 자 가운데서 찾느냐. 여기 계시지 않고 살아나셨느니라.
독실한 기독교 신자들은 바로 그 최초의 부활절날 아침 예수가 부활해 전 세계를 구원했다고 믿고 있다. 이것이 바로 기독교 신앙의 가장 근본이 되는 믿음이다. 오늘도 많은 순례자들이 고고학적으로 밝혀진 예수의 발자취를 따르지만 그것은 오직 신앙으로서만 완성될 수 있는 여정이다.
Archaeology and history, all these different sciences are marvelous helps to us if they can help us to be more sure of what we believe. But we need to remember that belief is faith. We are basing our faith on what is unseen.
In the past, archaeology and faith were more or less antagonistic. Faith tried to use archaeology to prove that it was true. Archaeology at times would be guided by faith, misguided by faith, to look for particular things. I think in recent years they have a much more beneficial relationship. That is to say, if Christian faith, or any faith, wants to have depth to it, it needs to understand its traditions in their historical context.
What archaeology does for us is contextualize the gospel story. We simply understand better when the Gospels say Jesus went here or he said this. Now we understand it because archaeology lays bare what it looked like, the kinds of things people were doing, the customs, the tools. That's the real value of archaeology. It doesn't really prove anything. It clarifies much.